गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस पार्ट फिफ्थ ऑफ द चैप्टर इंडिगो, ओके, बाय लुई फिश्चर, बाय लुई फिश्चर, ओके। एंड वी ऑल नो वेरी वेल दैट लुई फिश्चर हैज रिटन वन बुक बायोग्राफी ऑन महात्मा गांधी, एंड बुक नेम इज द लाइफ ऑफ महात्मा गांधी। एंड इंडिगो चैप्टर इज एन एक्सट्रैक्ट टेकन आउट फ्रॉम द बुक द लाइफ ऑफ महात्मा गांधी, ओके। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस पेज नंबर 50 and 51। सो इंडिगो, द थीम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज इफेक्टिव लीडरशिप कैन overcome any problem. Means if you have effective leadership, then you can overcome any problem, okay. So we have come to know in this chapter that Mahatma Gandhi had returned from South Africa in 1915, okay. And Mahatma Gandhi believed in non-violence. Mahatma Gandhi believed in non-violence and he had used non-violence, his principles, truth, non-violence. So he had used non-violence in his politics. So he had used non-violence as a political tool, and Louis Fischer was follower of Mahatma Gandhi, okay, was follower of Mahatma Gandhi. So this chapter is an interview. ये चैप्टर एक इंटरव्यू है. लुई फिश्चर हैड टेकन महात्मा गांधीज इंटरव्यू इन 1942 एंड इट वॉज अ सिंपल क्वेश्चन आस्क्ड बाय लुई फिश्चर, व्हाई डिड यू डिसाइड ब्रिटिशर्स लीव फ्रॉम इंडिया, Why did you want Britishers leave from India? आप Britishers को इंडिया से leave क्यों करवाना चाहते थे? It was a simple question, and then Mahatma Gandhi started the story. What happened and when did it come in his mind that Britishers should leave India, कि Britishers को जाना चाहिए हमारे देश से? Why did he decide that? Okay, so it was in 1916, which year beta? It was in 1916 when Mahatma Gandhi was addressing annual convention, okay, Indian National Congress ka usko wo address kar rahe the. So in 1916 what happened that in Lucknow a person, okay, so what happened in 1916? In 1916, what happened that when he was addressing annual convention, okay, in Lucknow, annual convention of the Indian National Congress. So in that year, in 1916, when he was attending seminar, okay, when he was addressing Indian National Congress, means there were around 2,301 delegates from different parts of India. So in that convention, what happened that a person named Rajkumar Shukla approached Gandhi. Rajkumar Shukla approached Gandhi and he wanted Gandhi to come to Champaran. He had approached Mahatma Gandhi and requested Mahatma Gandhi to come to Champaran. But Mahatma Gandhi had refused. Why? Because he had some fixed meetings. After Lucknow, he had to go to Kanpur and then other parts of India. So he refused. But Rajkumar Shukla wanted Mahatma Gandhi to come to Champaran, and he was determined for that, okay. And he followed Mahatma Gandhi everywhere. Wherever Mahatma Gandhi went, wherever Mahatma Gandhi went, jahan bhi Mahatma Gandhi jate, Rajkumar Shukla followed him. So at last Gandhi returned to ashram and Mahatma Gandhi was highly impressed with the tenacity, T-E-N-A-C-I-T-Y, determination of Rajkumar Shukla. And finally he agreed and he had decided what, when Mahatma Gandhi would go for Calcutta to attend some meeting, Rajkumar Shukla could take Mahatma Gandhi from there. Rajkumar Shukla approached Mahatma Gandhi, okay, in Calcutta. Then from Calcutta, both the persons, Mahatma Gandhi and Rajkumar Shukla, boarded the train for Patna, from Calcutta to Bihar, Patna. But Rajkumar Shukla did not take Mahatma Gandhi directly to Champaran. Why? He first of all wanted him to go to where? Kahan le jana jata tha? Rajendra Prasad house. Why? Because Rajendra Prasad was dealing cases of indigo sharecroppers. So basically, why did Rajkumar Shukla invite Mahatma Gandhi in Champaran? Actually, Rajkumar Shukla wanted Mahatma Gandhi to solve the problems of indigo sharecroppers. It was the reason, and everyone was in this view, had an opinion that Mahatma Gandhi could win the case. So he had also come to know about the cases of South Africa. So that's why he approached Gandhi. Rajendra Prasad was not at the house, and then we have come to know servants behaved very badly. So Rajendra Prasad jab ghar pe nahi thi to servants se bahut ganda vyavhar kiya, because they thought that Gandhi was an untouchable. So Mahatma Gandhi decided not to go to Champaran. He wanted to collect more information. For that sake he reached Muzaffarpur, okay, and over there he called all the lawyers, and the lawyers summarized the case, fees and all. And then Mahatma Gandhi said, stop going to law courts. Law courts jana band kariye. Stop going to law courts. Aap ye jana band kariye. Why? Because farmers were already crushed, fear stricken. Make them free from fear. Unko unke fear se azad karo. Then we have come to know that in that scenario Mahatma Gandhi reached Champaran. Okay, first of all he reached Champaran and he wanted to collect more information. Then he reached to where? Champaran. Wo Champaran jaate hain. We have completed up to here. And in Champaran what happened? That in Champaran he visited the secretary of the British Landlord Association. Actually he wanted the details of the landlord. So that's why he visited secretary of the British Landlord Association. But the secretary refused to show him the files and data, and he told that he was an outsider. And then secretary complained the matter to the British Official Commissioner in which चंपारण डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेड. जिस डिस्ट्रिक्ट में चंपारण आता था वहाँ कंप्लेन हो गया, त्रिहट डिवीजन. देन द ब्रिटिश ऑफिशियल कमिश्नर कॉल्ड महात्मा गांधी एंड बुलीड हिम, धमकाया उनको, एंड बुलीड हिम, स्कोल्डेड हिम टू लीव चंपारण, आप चंपारण छोड़ के चले जाइए. बट महात्मा गांधी रिफ्यूज. नेक्स्ट मॉर्निंग व्हेन महात्मा गांधी वॉज अटेंडिंग मीटिंग इन मोतिहारी, देन ही हैड कम टू नो व्हाट दैट अ विलेजर was beaten brutally. So he approached over there to meet him. But messenger of that area, Motihari ke police superintendent ka jo messenger tha, messenger drove Gandhi home. Messenger, Gandhi complied. Gandhi maan gaye raste mein. Complied means agreed, okay, obeyed the order, and he returned to his office. And then messenger of the police superintendent of which area? Motihari. Okay, so police superintendent's messenger gave him a slip and he told that please leave the area. Then he wrote what? He wrote, and this sentence made a change in the Indian scenario. Pura scenario change hota. How? He signed this receipt for his notice and wrote on it that he would disobey the order. So what did Mahatma Gandhi say? He would disobey the order. He would disobey the order. So it was a great thing for Mahatma Gandhi, because Mahatma Gandhi believed in non-violence and he never disobeyed anything. But on that day he wrote what? He would disobey the order. Means he did not leave Motihari, he did not leave Champaran, and he did not leave Bihar. Okay. So in that consequence, as a result, Mahatma Gandhi was called in court. He had to reach court. Okay. And police superintendent had filed a case against Mahatma Gandhi. Police superintendent of which area? Motihari ke police superintendent ne case kiya. Kiske khilaf? Mahatma Gandhi ke khilaf. Now we will see from here. In consequence, Gandhi received a summons to appear in the court next day. All night Gandhi remained awake, because he had to go to court. Usko court jana tha. And Gandhi was a, means you can say, Gandhi had a far-sighted vision. Wo dur ka sochte the, okay? And that's why Gandhi thought that if he would send to jail, then what would happen with the sharecroppers, and how that case would be solved. So that's why he sent the telegram in ashram. He sent the telegram to the lawyers to approach Motihari. Okay. He wanted all the lawyers to reach over there. Okay. Because he did not know what would be the consequence of the case in the Motihari. Motihari mein, court mein kya hone wala, he did not know. So for that reason, all night Gandhi remained awake. He telegraphed Rajendra Prasad to come from Bihar with influential friends. Okay. And he sent instructions to the ashram. Means he wanted, let ashram people should know what would happen. Kya hone wala. And maybe Gandhi not returned from the court. He would directly send to the jail. Kuch bhi ho sakta. That's why he sent the telegram to the ashram. He wired a full report to the viceroy. Yes, this was the great thing. He informed the viceroy. Jo viceroy hote hain, unko pura information that what was going on in Bihar, Motihari, Champaran. Kya chal raha hai? He wanted him to inform. Wo chahte the usko bhi information mile. So he had a vision. Mahatma Gandhi ka kya tha? He thought that viceroy could help him in the case. Or wo ye nahi chahte the viceroy help kare, wo ye chahte the viceroy should know what was the reality of the Champaran. So morning found the town. Now next day Mahatma Gandhi had to approach to court. Morning found the town of Motihari black with peasants. Morning mein all over Motihari means court, nearby in the court, peasants were there. They collected over there. Why? Because they did not know the, you can say, Gandhi's power. Unko Gandhi ka power ka nahi pata tha. So that's why they did not know Gandhi's record in South Africa. Gandhi ka jo record tha South Africa ka nahi pata tha. They thought that a person came to help them and now he was in problem. Unko laga ki ek person unki help karne aaya hai and he was in problem. So they were sad to know all this thing. So they had merely heard that Mahatma who wanted to help them was in trouble with the authorities. So their spontaneous means without force. Nobody compelled them, nobody forced them. But all of a sudden they collected and they were united. Wo ek saath ho gaye. Okay. And demonstration, they started to protest near the court. Unhone sabne vidroh karna shuru kiya Motihari court mein. Motihari court ki building ke samne. Okay. In thousands around the courthouse. Court building ke samne, they were in thousands. Oh, thousands mein the. Was the beginning of their liberation. And it showed that they were united. Mahatma Gandhi wanted it. Mahatma Gandhi yehi chahate the. What? Unity. Because महात्मा गांधी वंस टोल्ड दैट इफ यू आर यूनाइटेड यू कैन सॉल्व एनीथिंग, आप अगर यूनिटी में है यू कैन डू एनीथिंग. सो दैट्स वाई महात्मा गांधी वैन केम टू नो दैट पीजेंट्स एंड फार्मर्स वर इन ग्रुप दे वर यूनाइटेड, सो ही वॉज हैप्पी. ओके, लिबरेशन फ्रॉम द फियर ऑफ ब्रिटिश, सो दे ऑल वर रेडी टू टेक अ रिलीज टू टेक फ्रीडम फ्रॉम द ब्रिटिशर्स. द ऑफिशियल्स फेल्ट पावरलेस and the officials inside the court, they were powerless, and the even police officers, police superintendents, messenger officers and all were in what that you can say powerless. They were powerless. Why? Because they could not control the mob. Us crowd ko control karna mushkil tha. They could not fire them directly without a written order. They could not take decisions without Gandhi's cooperation. So they thought that now they had to discuss Gandhi, because Gandhi was the only person who could regulate them, jo unko control kar sakta, because for Gandhi they all were there. Are you getting my point? For Gandhi they all were there. He helped them regulate the crowd, and Mahatma Gandhi regulated the crowd, controlled the crowd. He was polite and friendly. Okay, he was polite and friendly. He managed the crowd. He made them understand, have a patience. उन्होंने उसको समझाया farmers को have patience. And then he was polite in front of the British officials. उनके सामने वो बोलता है. He was giving them concrete proof. Mahatma Gandhi was giving them concrete proof. What was concrete proof? Solid proof. महात्मा गांधी वॉज गिविंग दैम कंक्रीट प्रूफ, सॉलिड प्रूफ. सॉलिड प्रूफ दे रहे महात्मा गांधी ऑफ वॉट? सॉलिड प्रूफ डेट देयर माइट, ब्रिटिशर्स आपका जो पावर था, डेट देयर माइट हिदर दो टिल नाउ इट वॉज ड्रेडेड, मीन्स रिगार्डेड एज ए फियर. योर पावर वॉज रिगार्डेड एज ए फियर. अभी तक फार्मर्स हैड ए फियर विद यू, बट टूडे सी दे ऑल वर यूनाइटेड एंड दे ऑल वर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. आपके सामने ये फार्मर्स खड़े हैं. सो हिदर दो ड्रेडेड एंड अनक्वेश्चन अनचैलेंज, नो बडी रेज द क्वेश्चन अगेंस्ट यू, कुड बी चैलेंज बाई इंडियंस, बट टूडे सी योर पावर वॉज चैलेंज्ड बाई इंडियन पीसेंट्स. ओके, एंड इट वॉज अ ग्रेट थिंग फॉर गांधी. Government was baffled, confused, what to do, what should they do over there. Unko nahi samajh mein aa raha government ko. The prosecutor, lawyer and the person who is dealing the case from the government side. Okay, the prosecutor requested the judge to postpone the trial. Means if decision would be taken against Gandhi, the crowd would raise voice, and if not, then it was the insult of government official, British officials ka. So they were in dilemma what to do. So judge to postpone the trial. Apparently, okay, seemingly, it seemed the authorities wished to consult their superiors. Means it seemed that authorities wanted to discuss with the superiors. वो चाह रहे थे अपने जो वाइसराय लेवल के जो लोग उनसे डिस्कस करें what to do with this Gandhi, इस गांधी का क्या करें. So उन्होंने क्या किया, they would like to postpone the case, but see what did Gandhi say. Gandhi protested against the delay. Gandhi said no, he would not delay the case, and he read a statement pleading guilty. He agreed that he was at a fault, and this is the most important line for this chapter. He agreed that he was at a fault. वो agree करते हैं कि उन्होंने mistake किया है. He agreed that he was at a fault. Okay, and he was involved. He was involved. He told the court in a conflict of duties. In a conflict of duties, it is important thing. Why? Conflict of duties means what? Conflict means dwand. Conflict means in confusion. What? In dilemma. What? What kind of the conflict Gandhi was facing over there? He, please go through, then I'll make you understand. He was involved, he told the court, in conflict of duties. on the one hand not to set a bad example as a law breaker. Means what is the conflict of duties? Means he did not want to not to set an example as a lawbreaker. Means first thing is that he did not want to set himself as a lawbreaker. He did not want peasant should come to know ki wo lawbreaker hai. Nahi, wo nahi chahte ki wo lawbreaker bane. Means he told that he was against the system, but it was not there that he wanted to make himself hero, or he wanted to declare himself villain. No, he did not want to set an example as a law breaker. Then the first point is this: on the one hand, not to set a bad example as a law breaker, okay, and then on the other hand, to render the humanitarian and national service. So one hand, not to set a bad example or an example as a lawbreaker, or dusri taraf national service, okay. So this was the thing. He was in dilemma for that reason. He was in dilemma with that reason. Now he was not able to measure the scale, weigh the scale. Wo scale ko measure nahi kar pa rahe the, that he should not follow national service. क्या वो national service ना follow करे तब तो क्या होगा? He would not be a lawbreaker. और अगर वो lawbreaker बनते हैं तो फिर साथ में national. So what should he take? उनको क्या लेना है? Lawbreaker का tag या national service का tag? So he was in confusion and finally he read the statement in a guilty. उन्होंने माना that he had broken the law. उन्होंने माना that he had broken the law. So on the one hand, not to set a bad example as a lawbreaker, on the other hand, to render the humanitarian and national service for which he had come. So he thought that what would be best. Then he heard his voice of conscience. उन्होंने अपनी voice of conscience सुना. Conscience means to know what is right, what is wrong. And then he considered, it is right. Ye right hai. What? National service and humanitarian ground. Okay. Always national service comes first. National service and humanitarian ground always come first. So he, humanitarian national service for which he had come, he disregarded the order to leave. उन्होंने बोला that I had disobeyed the order to leave, okay, but in obedience to the higher law of our being, but in front of your order, I think that my national service is higher. आपके order से ज़्यादा national service का order high है. क्यों? क्योंकि तो ना he disregarded the order to leave. Not for want of respect for lawful authority. ऐसा नहीं है, he did not respect the lawful authority, but for in obedience to the higher law of our voice, means our wing, my voice of conscience, my soul's voice is what? To help the humanity and to do the national service first. First comes national service. He asks the penalty due, so you can put a fine on me. Okay, penalty due. Magistrate announced that he would pronounce sentence after a 2-hour race. So magistrate said that he wanted 2-hour recess. 2-hour recess for what? He wanted to give decision after 2 hour, and asked Gandhi to furnish bail, to give bail for those 120 minutes. Gandhi refused, no, because he told that he was not at fault. He was at a fault because he had broken the what? Law. But he would not furnish bail. The judge released him without bail. When the court resettled, the judge said he would not deliver the judgment for several days. Judge said that he was not able to give the decision on that day and he wanted some more time. Meanwhile, he allowed Gandhi to remain at liberty, freedom. Rajendra Prasad Babu, last paragraph. Rajendra Prasad Babu Brij Kishore Babu, Maulana Mazrul Haq, and several other famous lawyers had arrived from Bihar. They conferred with Gandhi, they talked with Gandhi. What would they do if he was sentenced to prison? Then Gandhi raised a question in front of all the lawyers who were over there. What would they do? Aap kya karte agar mujhe jail hoti? Because Gandhi was released, okay, without bail. Gandhi asked. Then one senior lawyer replied, they had come to advise and help him. Hum yahan pe aapki help karne aaye hain. If he went to jail, there would be nobody to advise and they would go home. Aapko agar koi help nahi milti, आप नहीं लेते, आप चले जाते जेल, देन दे वुड रिटर्न टू देयर जॉब और देयर प्लेसेस. सो देन गांधी वुड रेज अ क्वेश्चन, व्हाट अबाउट द इनजस्टिस टू द शेयर क्रॉपर्स? देन वी विल स्टडी दिस पार्ट टुमारो. व्हाट वुड हैपन व्हेन गांधी रेज अ क्वेश्चन, व्हाट वुड बी द इनजस्टिस टू द शेयर क्रॉपर्स? वी विल कम टू नो टुमारो. हम ये कल पढ़ेंगे कि गांधी ने जब ये क्वेश्चन किया, व्हाट would be injustice about the share croppers. Okay, we will come to know. But up to now, go through the part 50, page number 50 and 51. Thank you. Have a nice day. Ma'am, 5 minutes.